Welcome to Semana Santa in Madrid, or as we call it, Hell on Earth. It's Semana Santa, it's Holy Week, it's Easter here in Madrid. And Lara was telling me it didn't used to be this popular, or your mum was saying.
Yeah. It's very touristy now.
It's kind of crazy. So I've been here 14 years, and I remember like seeing some processions and stuff. When we think of Semana Santa, I think usually we think of maybe Andalusia, maybe some of the northern cities with processions. I'll put some lovely photos up now so you can see the drama on these other cities. But Madrid, it seems to be getting more and more popular with processions every day. So we thought, Laura thought, it was Laura's idea, let's do a video about Holy Week. And holy hell, it's a hell of a week. See what I did there, a little Tuesday. But because this is obviously pretentious gastro traveler, we thought we could make it into a bit of a foodie video as well. So as well as
what
showing you... what to eat, exactly. Because there are these dishes, one of which we're going to have for lunch, I didn't even know about, and Laura was like, Luke, it's a famous dish. We're going to have a famous dish, more on that later. But because this is Semana Santa, in theory we don't have meat because the body of Christ and all that.
So
lots
religious.
Of fish. But we're going to start off in a very historic bar, and we're going to have their speciality, and then we'll talk a bit more. First bar is Casa Labra from 1860. It's also where the PSOE, the Socialist Party, was founded. There's always a line. Got to make sure we keep our place in this queue. So while we're waiting here, because we've probably got a good wait, I'll tell you a little bit about today. Well, Laura told me today is Jueves Santo, Saint Thursday, which is when old Jeezy Greasy dies. Lols. No, not lols.
And it's a holiday here in Spain.
So the speciality here is cod, bacalao, that great Basque invention, which is not meat. So they do cod croquetas and cod, they call them tajadas, which is like a chunk of battered cod, almost like fish and chips. So hopefully, if we have time, this is a very long queue, we'll try and get one of each, maybe a cheeky vermouth, because it's aperitivo o'clock, and then we'll head on to lunch afterwards. Still waiting. In future, by the way, in future, don't wait for places. Go do that. It's a cod croqueta. And this is a tajada. Gonna have lunch in Casa Ciriaco, another 100-something-year-old restaurant. Ah, bit windy, sorry. Painted red, and why was it painted red, Laura?
I don't know.
These restaurants were traditionally painted red, so the people knew that there was wine in them. So in the old days, people didn't read, so if you put vino and cerveza on your bras, no one's gonna know, but if you paint it red, they know there's wine. Menos mal que hemos reservado. So this place is about as traditional as it gets. It's full of old ladies. It's a very good sign for me for a taverna. And they specialize in sort of traditional Madrid fare. There's a word in Spanish which we use in Madrid, which is called castizo. Castizo is like authentically Spanish in Madrid. Lots of kind of rustic fare. So I've ordered a dish called potaje, more on that later. Oh yes. So I have potaje, which is this cod, chickpea, spinach stew. I like all these things. English guys react to Semana Santa food. By the way, I've got a nice fat glass of Rioja. Let's try that. It's red. So I like that. Yeah. As they say in the US of A, this is my jam. Like a revuelto, fried eggs with cod. What's underneath it? ¿Qué está ahí debajo? Just cod. Good. All right, that's, I would say, 50-50 bacalao and chunks of garlic. Quite a lot of garlic still. Very good. Oh, Holy Week lunch done. Lots of cod, lots of chickpeas. Now, that's lunch done. Time for a siesta, which means I'm going to go back to work for a bit. And then later on, maybe tomorrow, on what's it called?
Viernes Santo.
Holy Friday. Good Friday, I think, in English. We're going to try and see some processions and probably eat some more. You ready?
Yes.
Viernes Santo?
Also a holiday.
Yeah, not for us. We're working. No. But for the real Easter fans, it's another big day. Big day. So hopefully we're going to see some processions. Now, it has been raining a lot. It's currently raining a little bit.
In all of Spain also.
What was the one they missed? They stopped the Madruga?
They stopped Madruga. It's been raining a lot in Sevilla and Cadiz. They had to cancel processions yesterday. And...
One second. Sorry about that. A lot of wind. So they had to cancel some big procession, right?
Yeah. Spain.
Everyone was like crying in the streets.
It's
now,
very dramatic.
I'm not religious, so when I see people crying, I'm like, you're mental. However, we were discussing a little bit. There's the belief side of things, and then there's the tradition side of things. And I was thinking, like, imagine you're like waiting for this all year.
They've been practicing
and they're taking it. Oh yeah, the crazy people, I think, are the normal people. But the people,
yes.
Imagine you're waiting all year to take these things around, and suddenly it rains. That's kind of annoying. So hopefully we'll see some Madrid ones, because they deserve our YouTube video. So there is a possibility they might not even do the processions, which is a shame. So earlier today I went around the neighborhood and I popped into the San Isidro church, which is a big one we're walking past now, and I saw a big old Jesus Christ with all candles. And then I went to another church in La Latina, which is the second oldest church, I think it's El Salvador, and they had a little Jesus and a little Virgin Mary there, really, really pretty.
Pasos.
I think we call them floats. And here comes the Jesus police, because I was being naughty. So we're arriving at our first procession. Just a thing you're going to see. Lots of pointed hoods. Now, this has nothing to do with the Ku Klux Klan. This is dating back to the Inquisition times, where they had the capirotes, these hooded things that was placed on the naughty convicts. It's a bit of shame and penitence.
Yeah.
And it was later part of the imagery taken on by those horrid people in America in the 19th century. So if you ever come to Spain, don't worry, you're safe.
Are you excited, Laura?
I mean, yes, but at the same time, too many
left the craziness of Plaza Mayor area, and now we're going to get some food. So we're heading into the depths of La Latina, and we're going to go to a little Andalusian bar. Why? Because in Andalusia, Easter's very popular. So what, Luke? Well, they have lots of meat-free dishes, including a specialty called tortillitas de camarones. So we're going to this bar that opens in a bit, so we're going to wait outside so we're first in, and then have some Easter nibbles. Are you excited? Right, shrimp fritter. This is like, with manzanilla, it's like the perfect pairing in Sanlúcar de Barrameda. There's also famous bars. This little tiny shrimp with parsley, garlic oil. Very, very good. This is cazón, which is marinated dogfish in a kind of a pickled escabeche.
Very good.
Right, another classic one, papas aliñadas, which is with melva, which is lovely, bonito, ventresca, a good quality tuna, with potatoes, with onion, garlic, parsley, loads of olive oil. That's really good. Happy Easter, everyone.
For dessert, we're gonna have what's the most famous Easter food in all of Spain?
Torrijas.
Torrijas, how would you describe torrijas?
Torrijas is fried bread that is soaked in milk. So you
Or wine.
Or wine, yeah.
Not as common.
I like that one.
No. We're gonna get one though if we can. Get one of each. I said the other day, it's like Spain's better version of French toast, and Laura was like,
It's not the same.
It's better though. And maybe with some cinnamon
Very
on top?
Good. Yes. Cinnamon sugar and with eggs, and then you fry them. And it's...
What better place to have a torrija than the Casa de la Torrija?
So with a torrija, you have to have a sweet wine. That is the size of a baby. It's leaking like juices and butter. Look, it looks like a chicken Kiev. Oh, this is the best sweet food Spain makes, but you only really get it in Easter, unless you come to La Casa de la Torrija. It's been here since 1907.
That is the end of Saintly Friday. But there are two more days left of religious things, so hopefully we'll see some more stuff. I'm really full. Are you full?
Un poco.
That torrija was the size of a small child. So that will be the end of our Friday, and maybe see you for some more things in the coming days. Good night.
It finally happened. So it's finally raining. We're going to try and see one more event, but it might get cancelled by the rain. Jesus has woken up. It's Resurrection Day. So we're going to toast his return somewhere a bit warmer and drier. So if we're able to, we're going to try and get into El Riojano, which is a 19th century cafe with a hidden dining room. We're going to try and get some little sweets and a cup of coffee, because it's stopped raining a little bit, but it's miserable cold. ¿Qué tal? ¿Cómo estás?
Bien, ¿y tú qué tal?
Bueno, mojado.
Ya.
Es horrible. So we're in El Riojano, we're right at the back. Fortunately, I used to come here with food tours, so I'm quite friendly with some of the waitresses, which is great. So they've got a nice seat at the back for us, which is cool. We've ordered, of course, torrijas again. We've got one of milk because it's tradition, but we also got the wine one, which is made instead of milk, you use a reduced moscatel, usually a semi-sweet Spanish wine, again with all the other ingredients, and you bathe them, the bread in that bit. I think I've only had it once, this is going to be fun for me to try again. And a Bartolillo, which is very Madrid. I'm going to translate it directly here. It's a fried dough or mass filled with pastry cream. And it's typical for Madrid. I don't think I've ever had one, and it sounds absolutely banging. A couple of coffees and back to the rain. So apparently Laura has once brought me a Bartolillo. I'm sorry.
Right, Laura's trying the milk one, the classic one.
There's a lot of, I think,
a lot of the amoeba, the syrup.
Yeah.
Right? Yeah? Is it good?
I think it's not as warm, it's better.
I think these guys won an award for like best torrija one year as well.
Well, está super rica.
So this is a torrija of wine. It already looks different. It's a lot, not drier, but it's less gloopy. Smells kind of like wine. Now, that tastes alcoholic. It tastes like reduced sweet wine. That's really interesting. I don't think I've ever had one of these then. So the idea of the wine one, which I know sounds a bit weird, is because historically, especially in Madrid and places where it's less verdant, milk was important. Milk was more expensive than wine, because wine was just an easy village thing, and it still is today considered just part of the food stuff. So the wine ingredient was cheaper to use than milk. Milk was important for cheese, for various other more important dishes than bathing some bread. That's why we still have this tradition of the torrija de vino, although I think, as interesting as it is, I am team torrija de leche. While I've got you, let's try the Bartolillo. Now this looks like it's going to be messy. People will know that I'm not the biggest fan of Spanish desserts. However, if you come to Spain, you see anything with crema pastelera, with the pastry cream, it's the greatest thing on the planet. So I'm having another one. So we're arriving at the Plaza Mayor, the main square again, hopefully to see the jubilant finale of Semana Santa, which is the tamborrada. It's a big, berobed drum fest. Never seen this ever, didn't even know it existed. This is going to be new for me as well. We were headbanging. That was amazing. Well, it still is. It's still happening, as you can see. Millions of people.
Many people.
Very impressive. And it didn't rain. So that's the end of all the activities. But it's not the end of the video. Cheers. Right, we come to the end in one of these crazy bars near my house called Parnasso, where the inside looks like it's filled with every antique shop and secondhand shop in the UK. I love it. It's mad. Having a little beer just to bring us home. Semana Santa Madrid. It's kind of wild. It's kind of crazy. There's a billion people. There's lots of food to eat. There's lots of stuff to see. Andalusia is famous. I get it. If you want to have a good experience of mixing Semana Santa with Madrid or a capital city, you should totally come. And because Lara's behind the camera, I'll do the last bit. Like and subscribe. And toodaloo, kangaroo.